Hi, folks. Dr. Bob McCauley. During this virus crisis, the nation is running out of meat. We are low on protein. I have a solution. The virus crisis has caught up with the meat industry, the slaughterhouses, and the dairy industry. They're dumping tens of thousands of gallons of milk. They're killing chickens. They're killing pigs. They're getting rid of the meat. We're just not buying enough of it, mainly because all the restaurants are closed, and they buy up most of the meat, most of the chicken. So Tyson Foods, this is one of the largest producers of chickens in the world. I think it's the largest in the United States. And they announced that they've got serious problems here. They're laying off massive amounts of people. And it looks like we're going to have a protein shortage in this country. Protein is the most misunderstood nutrient out there. It was only discovered back in the 19th century. They didn't even know what the protein existed before that. So a lot of people think, well, we need this huge amount of protein, and you know, the center of your plate should be this big piece of meat. I will remind you that meat is only about, on average, around 15%, maybe 17% meat, and the rest is fat and other stuff in there. So we're really moving toward a crisis here. I'm not getting enough protein, but actually the truth is you really don't need that much protein. The USDA has the food pyramid, and and they make recommendations on how much you should eat of something. Well, they've told us that we need 51 grams of protein. Well, that really just means, as I said, 51 grams of meat. You couldn't possibly eat that amount of protein. If you try to eat 51 grams of protein a day, I mean, you would be on an all-protein diet. So what they really mean is that you need about really 6 to 10 grams of protein per day at the very most. Animal protein is a very, very inefficient way to obtain protein for the human body. What animal protein is just like it sounds, it's protein. So what is protein? Protein is amino acids that are all been put together in these long, complex chains. Your body puts them together with these little peptide chains. That's protein chain. So what you've got to do with any of these protein forms that you get from an animal, meat, fish, eggs, or dairy, you need to take that protein chain. Your body needs to break it down, and then it needs to take those amino acids and then turn them into human proteins that we require. So this is a very inefficient process. And when you cook the meat, the protein chain, since they're held together with these little peptide bonds, it becomes messy. It just becomes like a big mess, and that becomes very dangerous to your health. So where are you going to get your protein if you can't get it from meat, fish, eggs, or dairy? Now, I've been a vegetarian for 39 years, and as you can tell, I'm falling apart here. I'm on my last legs because I don't eat animal protein. It's really one of the worst things you can put into your body is animal protein, meat, fish, eggs, or dairy, primarily because we cook it. We always cook the animal. Very rarely do we eat anything raw. Sushi is one of the few examples of this. So in an emergency, or just as a lifestyle, where would you get protein? Well, I've got the perfect protein source right here, Spirulina and chlorella. There it is, 60% protein. Again, meat, 15% protein, 1/5. So this is 60% protein. It also has a broad array of nutrients. The most nutritionally dense foods in the world, very high in fiber. Chlorella is very high in fiber. So they're really just the perfect foods, but they're really the perfect protein substitutes or sources. I like to say substitute. I don't like to call it a substitute. I think meat, fish, eggs, and dairy should become a substitute for spirulina and chlorella. It's all how you look at things, right? Absolutely. If you have protein shortage and you can't get meat, fish, eggs, or dairy, and let me tell you something, this is coming. We are destroying the food chain supplies in this country. You better learn how to grow your own food. I grow mine out in my backyard. I do a lot of sprouting during the winter. You just need seeds for that. Incredibly powerful, healthy food. Sprouts are amazing things. But you better get used to learning how to garden, or having a garden inside your apartment. And looking for alternative protein sources. The two best sources on the planet for protein, without any doubt, spirulina and chlorella. Got the answer right there. Way ahead of the curve on that one. Dr. Bob, I'll see you next time.